Silverado, and the Blue Ridge, searing thousands of acres in Orange County, California.
Rise up, sons and daughters of the Most High God. Wake up, Christians. Shake off this great delusion and stand in the light of God's truth. Everything you see outwardly is a representation of a great war going on in the spirit realm. And our souls cannot afford to be blind to our failures to pray diligently for the future course of this nation. The riots in the streets, cities burned, buildings destroyed, civil unrest, continual pandemic paranoia, and a fiery rage on both political sides. These are clear manifestations of a war raging in a realm we cannot see. And whether you like it or not, we're all in the midst of it and have a role in the outcome. A massive storm has been manifesting thick darkness over our lands for years, but we fail to heed the warnings to prepare for what's coming. Satan's greatest warriors are rising up in mass, and we Christians are at home in pajamas watching virtual services and waiting on Jesus to come back. Instead of armoring up for spiritual war, we are rejoicing in a victory we never fought for. We are pompous and proud with no humility or enduring prayer. We pass the offering plates while the world seeks answers only a true gospel can give. Christians, we must repent for believing the false prophecies and the lies. I repent for believing in all false words spoken by those who claim to speak for God. So many have made a mockery of Christianity by grabbing a hold of every false narrative, conspiracy theory, and ridiculous commentary one could find. That Donald Trump would conquer the evil left's agenda, retain control of the White House. You made him your King Cyrus, and you lost sight of reality. You wanted it to be true so badly that you forgot to pray for wisdom and discernment. You were so convinced of victory that you failed to pray on your knees for the will of God for this country. You believed so blindly that Donald Trump would save the world that you seemed to forget that Jesus Christ already has through the power of his gospel if we only believe. If the motto truly is where we go one, we go all, then let's go together to the throne of grace and repentance because we have let ourselves become so utterly deceived. Christians, we're fighting in the flesh within a political arena without understanding the implications of a spiritual war. Our identity should only ever be in Christ alone. We have too desperately gripped a political party instead of gripping the garment of Christ. We have become so distracted by political theater instead of being immersed in fulfilling the perfect will of God. We have somehow believed that our faithful Christian service is to become an activist, an ally with a conservative cause. But what good does it do if we neglect the heart of God? Up and down the streets of America's largest cities, I have cried out for the nation to repent. Tens of millions of people witnessed this call and then did nothing. I obeyed the voice of the Lord and spoke a word for Donald Trump in front of the White House to call this nation to repentance through prayer and fasting. He did not. God's voice spoke upon the wind, but we denied reality. We had every chance, but our pride puffed us up and deceived our hearts. The blood of the innocent runs like water upon the face of this defiled, godless land. Our Lord Jesus Christ is blasphemed by the multitudes. Christianity is treated as a religion of hatred and intolerance, and believers have been pushed to the fringes of society due to the public's outrage at the idea of living by godly principles. Joe Biden and his administration are a representation of the pure evil that has taken over our country, and judgment is surely at our door. When will America repent? Where are the men of God who long for the forgiveness and restoration of our country? Tens of thousands of believers can be gathered together in Washington, D.C. to see a Christian concert and hear a few big-name leaders say a few words, but where are the souls at the altar weeping for the sins of our nation? Why is the church so silent during a time when our voices should be at their loudest? God will not be mocked. What a man sows, that shall he reap. We have sown evil and shall reap destruction. The days upon us are only the beginning. Repentance shall escape us. We shall search for it, but it shall be found wanting. The day of the Lord is nigh. Who shall stand?